This video will show you how to set up and program your Intermatic ET8000 series 7-day Astronomic electronic timer control. Make sure to set the correct voltage using the voltage selection switch on the back of the time mechanism before installation. Please refer to your device manual for details. For timers with more than one channel, you can also choose to operate in simultaneous, independent, or pulse mode. This is set by the placement of jumpers on the back of the time mechanism. Again, for detailed instructions, refer to your device manual. For initial setup, press the mode button until set and date appear in the upper area of the display. Next, use the plus or minus buttons to choose the current month. When the correct month is shown, press enter to advance. Again, use the plus or minus buttons to set the day, and then press enter. Now select the year, but do not press enter. Instead, press the mode button to enter the time setting screen. Use the plus or minus buttons to set the current time, being mindful of the AM/PM setting. Holding down either button will advance from minutes to hours. Once that's set, press Mode to select your astronomic zone. Use this map, which is also included in the written instructions, to determine if you are in the north, center, or south zone. For this example, we are in the center zone, so we will select center. Press the Mode button to advance. Based on your zone, the sunup time for load 1 is displayed. This can be changed to match your location's exact sunrise time, including any offset that you may want to include with the plus or minus buttons. For this example, we will leave the sunrise setting where it is and press mode to advance. If you have more than one circuit, the sunup time for load 2 is now displayed. This is useful in environments involving lighting with different warm-up times. For this example, we will leave load 2 at the default sunup time as well and press mode to advance. Now the sunset time for load 1 is displayed. Again, this can be changed to match your location's exact sunset time, including any offset that you may want to include with the plus or minus buttons. But for this example, we will leave the sunset time for load 1 where it is and press mode to advance. We will leave the sunset time for load 2 at the default setting as well and press mode to advance. Set, astro, and on-off events are visible in the display, indicating that we are in the astronomic programming mode. Astronomic schedules are created before fixed on and off schedules are programmed. Load 1 is also visible, indicating that this on event will only affect load 1. The on event for load 1 is set to occur at sunset. Use the day button to select the day or days you would like the on event to occur. As well as individual days, you can choose every day of the week, Monday through Friday, or weekends. For this example, we will select Monday through Friday. Now press enter to set an astronomic on event for load 2. Pressing the day button will set the on event at sunset. Continue pressing the day button until the day or days you would like to set for load 2 are visible. For this example, we do not want an astronomic program for load 2, so we will press the day button until the time is displayed as dashes. Press enter next to set the astronomic sunrise off event for load 1. Press the day button to choose which days. Again, we will select Monday through Friday. Now press enter next to set the astronomic off event for load 2. Because we did not set an astronomic on event for load 2, we will not set an off event either. Now press the mode button to set a fixed program. You will see set, fixed, and on-off events in the left side of the display and an event number on the right. On events will be odd numbers and off events will be even. To set the on event, use the day button to select the days you would like the on event to occur. For this example, we will set it for Monday through Friday. You can choose which loads are affected by the fixed event with the on-off buttons below the load indicators. For this example, we will set a fixed on event for load 2 only. Now press the plus or minus buttons to select the time. Again, you can quickly advance time by holding down either button. For this example, we will select 9 p.m. Now press Enter Next to set a fixed off time. Again, use the Day button to choose the days. As with the On event, we will set the Off event to Monday through Friday. As before, use the plus or minus buttons to choose the time. For this example, we will choose 11 p.m. Make sure the correct loads are selected for the off event using the on-off buttons below each load indicator. To set another fixed program, press Enter, or you can press Mode to exit the programming mode. The current time and date will be displayed, as well as the current status of each load. Auto indicates that your programs will automatically run as scheduled. And you're done! You have now completed setup of your Intermatic ET8000 series timer and set an Astronomic program for load 1 and a fixed program for load 2. And if you have any questions or need help at any step in the process, you can call or email technical support at the contact information listed on the screen. And be sure to check out our other videos on YouTube or visit our webpage for more tutorials.